All of us have been gifted moment-to-moment opportunities to choose living a conscious lifestyle as opposed to living an unconscious lifestyle. Why? Because everything that we consume, whether it's the food we eat or the media we consume, the people we surround ourselves with, our environment, our thoughts, everything literally shapes who we are. It shapes our personality, it shapes the brain, it shapes our reality. So because of that, I like to keep what some of you may call as a positive lifestyle. And today I wanted to share with you all the things that I do and some additional things that you guys can do. Now, the reason why I do this is because if some of you are really serious about changing your life for the better, it starts with rewiring your brain, keeping a very healthy lifestyle. That's a part of it. And it's an important part of it. And also staying at a stronger vibrational state in order for you to also deal with the negative stuff going on. All the stuff that I do in my daily life here. So I begin my day by rolling out of bed and then doing a few stretches. I do the stretches just to wake me up. And on the days that I have yoga class, I go for the yoga class and I do a full hour of yoga. Once I'm back, I take some time to just write down the immediate thoughts that are coming up in a loop in my head, just to clear my mind for that day. I have a journal to do that. Once the thoughts have been cleared out of my way, I sit down on my bed and I just close my eyes and I go into my heart just for a few moments, trying to connect to the energy of gratitude, of love. So again, all of this just takes a few moments. It's not like a long process. Even for those of you who have early mornings where you have to rush to work, it's highly possible for you to get this done. Breathing, okay, these things are absolutely essential for me. In my daily practice is I do a little bit of belly breathing, mindful breathing, and a few breathing techniques. Again, all of this takes few moments, just 1 or 2 minutes, you know, of just breathing. It's just a way to calm down the nerves before you start the day. Then I go ahead and I take my shower. Once I'm done with my shower, I go have my breakfast. Now, I keep a very clean vegetarian diet and I have an extra protein source of I take this protein powder that's made out of soy and wheat protein, and I put that in a mango. So I have a organic mango tree, so I have organic mangoes. This is a season for mangoes in India. So I take organic mangoes, make a smoothie alongside jaggery. I'm sure you guys know what jaggery is. And then I have that once every single day. But that's when I either head out to get, you know, if I'm working out, I will head out and I will do my focused work. So the work that I do during the day is extremely focused, whether I'm doing it at home or whether I'm out. So at home, the first thing I would do is obviously clean up my room, and I will sit down, I would light some incense. I'd put on some very empowering music. Now, this is a very important part that I want you guys to notice. Music will shape a lot about yourself. There is always piano music, classical music, music for concentration, music for creativity. That's always playing when I'm working. On the times that I'm taking a break or cleaning my room, getting ready, having a bath, I always have reggae music. Higher conscious music that keeps me, you know, singing along, dancing along, constantly in that state of a very fun vibe. You know, the vibe is always high all throughout the days. Listen to conscious music, music that has very powerful lyrics, positive lyrics. It's very important. Okay, once I'm done with my lunch, I continue working. Now I do take breaks. Now my work is not like just sitting in front of the laptop and doing work. My work is varied work. Like, I do different things every hour, so I don't get fatigued. I'm constantly up on my game doing different things. So I have rehearsals, I have vocal practice, I have writing a song, recording a song, teaching class, doing a client, one-on-one coaching, writing an article, whatever. Every hour is something different, or every few hours is something different. So once I am done in the evening, I will do a few moments of grounding meditation. So this could be going out, you know, usually for me, I like to go out for walks, but I also get, because I'm so focused on the work, I want to stay around the laptop and things like that. So I sit down and I do mindfulness every single day. Is very important for me to do mindfulness. So I do my mindfulness meditation, ground myself, root myself, be, you know, do my present moment awareness thing. So what do I see? What do I hear? So I'm, you know, building more awareness of the present moment. And then I will eat my dinner. And once after I finish eating my dinner, I will come back to my room, maybe get some more work done or just chill out for some time. But at night, I do two very, very important things, which is like my secret to life. Is at night also, I do a gratitude session, but I do an elaborate gratitude session. So my gratitude session could span like a good 20 minutes of giving thanks, talking to the divine. I sit and have long conversations with the sky. I will sit on the window and I will look out either at the sky or the tree in front of me, anything that I can project the perception of the divine. So I have conversations with the divine where I tell the divine, you know, I give thanks for everything, and I, you know, talk about the things that I would like help with and the things that I would like to bring into my reality. Just have a chat with the divine, you know, it's so empowering, it's so energizing. And then I will end with the most powerful part of my day, which is I do one full hour of the Ho'oponopono Hawaiian cleaning technique of saying to the divine, I love you, I'm sorry for being unconscious of this. Please forgive me for not being aware of it. Thank you for forgiving me, allowing me to let go of that data, and for cleansing me. I take no toxic substances inside of me at all. Now, I can't help things that come from food, but apart from that, I don't smoke. I do not take any form of alcohol at all, no forms of alcohol. I don't take any form of drugs. So I keep a very clean body. I drink basically like 2 to 3 of these. This is a lot of water a day, okay? It's a lot of water. Constantly have water with me. Now on the days that I am traveling or I have performances, I incorporate all of this stuff on the go. I will do all my stretches, my writing down, my breathing, my gratitude on the go. So water. That means the water has memory. You can actually say to the water, I love you, and charge this water, and you can start drinking this water and drinking the energy of love. The water has prana energy, so you can be having a shower, you can intend that the water is cleansing you off of anything that you don't need for the day, and just kind of melting you and relaxing you, and then you kind of move through the day. So these are conscious practices that you can start up, you know, even if you just take one out of what I've said today and just put that one into your daily life, it's going to make a big difference, because all of this is cumulative stuff. Today is my everyday lifestyle, and it and additional stuff that you guys can do to take back for your life, positive practices, right? There's no one thing that if the reason why you're doing all of this is big enough, you will stay with it consistently. If the reason isn't big enough, then you'll do it for 2 days, and then on the third day, you'll kind of be enough. So you want to make sure that you really want to improve your life and you're done with the suffering. So really, really implement it into your life and stick with it. So I wish you all the best, and I hope that your life flourishes for the best. And thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon with another video. Thank you. Love you. Namaste.